It can generally make an extra roughly 10 to 25 wheel horsepower compared to the Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Automotive, here today with a video on BMW EWG versus PWG. What is the difference? PWG and EWG both refer to turbocharger wastegate design, where PWG stands for pneumatic wastegates and EWG stands for electronic wastegates. So this is a popular topic in the BMW world, since when BMW first started mass producing turbocharged engines, beginning with the N54 in 2007, BMW was using pneumatic wastegates, and then BMW around model year 2014, and specifically the F chassis, had started largely shifting to electronic wastegates. So this is a very popular topic for some engines like the BMW N20 and N55, which were both in the middle of their lifespans when BMW had started switching from PWG to EWG. In this video, I'm mostly going to reference the N55 as well as the N20 a little bit, since those are the two engines that really come up the most when discussing electronic versus pneumatic wastegate design. Again, it was around model year 2014, so you can see the differences in design. And if you're in that gray area and have one of those years and models that you're unsure if it's EWG or PWG, you can reference this picture, try to get a glimpse of your own turbocharger and wastegate setup, and that will give you a good idea as to whether you have the electronic or pneumatic wastegates. Now, with some of the basics out of the way, how do EWG and PWG actually work? So pneumatic wastegates rely on vacuum to actually open and close the wastegate of the turbocharger. And ultimately, the wastegate is what controls how much exhaust and how much air actually flows over the turbine wheel. And so ultimately, wastegates are directly responsible for controlling your boost. So again, the biggest thing with pneumatic wastegates is, again, that requires vacuum, and so that does require the addition of a vacuum pump as well as vacuum lines to actually control the wastegate and, again, ultimately control the boost. Now, with the electronic wastegates, as the name suggests, this is all controlled electronically, so there is no reason for vacuum lines or a vacuum pump, which is a good thing for reliability and really simplicity of turbocharger design and really the overall design of the engine, not having to use any of those vacuum lines or vacuum pumps directly to the turbocharger wastegate. Moving on to EWG versus PWG pros and cons. Starting off with PWG, unfortunately, there really aren't any benefits to pneumatic wastegate control over electronic wastegate control. And ultimately, it just leaves room for additional issues like problems with the vacuum pumps, issues in leaks from the vacuum lines. So overall, PWG just is a little bit clunkier and a little more challenging and complex of a design compared to the electronically controlled wastegates, which again is all controlled electronically, and so that does give you much more precise wastegate and boost control. It again improves reliability by eliminating the need for running vacuum lines and having a vacuum pump to actually power the wastegate of the turbocharger or turbochargers. And then lastly, specifically on the BMW N55 engine, it does actually deliver more power, especially on the top end. Now, some of that boils down to the electronic boost control and ultimately just having better control over those wastegates and that boost pressure, so that's what really helps it build more power, especially up top. However, one other thing that's important to mention here is a lot of the extra power that a BMW N55 EWG sees over the PWG engines is due to the fact that with the EWG change, BMW did actually make the turbocharger ever so slightly larger, specifically the exhaust wheel or the turbine wheel, and the N55 EWG is also going to have a larger downpipe as BMW had moved from a 3.5-inch to a 4-inch downpipe. So those two factors are going to play a big role in the N55 EWG making more power, especially up top. So with all of that out of the way, does EWG versus PWG really matter in the grand scheme? The answer to that is mostly yes, but to some extent also no. So if you're looking to heavily modify an N20 or an N55, regardless of whether you have a PWG or EWG turbo, if you're looking to actually upgrade the turbocharger, the difference in power and performance between the two is going to be very minimal to non-existent. However, However, EWG still does have that inherent benefit of offering better reliability and ultimately better, more precise boost control. So those EWG models are always going to have that benefit. Looking at them with the stock turbochargers and comparing EWG versus PWG more directly, again, the N55 EWG is capable of more power with a tune and basic bolt-on mods. It can generally make an extra roughly 10 to 25 wheel horsepower compared to the PWG models. And again, on top of that, the better reliability with no vacuum lines and no vacuum pumps required to operate and control those wastegates. And again, that better boost control. So in those senses, yes, EWG is a big upgrade over PWG models, especially on the N55. But as I mentioned, once you start modifying these cars and really taking things to the next level with things like fueling upgrades, turbo upgrades, etc., then EWG really becomes a lot less beneficial over the PWG models. So just something to keep in mind if you are in the market for an N20 or N55 EWG or PWG model. It does matter on stock turbochargers, but if you're looking to upgrade the turbos, then it does matter a lot less. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.